Hello everybody. I'm gonna start posting gear videos. I said I was gonna do it on the last run that I posted, and I didn't do it, so I'm sorry about that. I felt bad about it, and I'm gonna start uploading gear videos now every time that I post a run up here, because I know that it helps people out, and everybody is always wondering what they should run. So anyway, I'm gonna just look through the gear real quick, and then after that I'll give a little explanation for what I like to run and why. This is just my light set that I use on everything except for bosses, and here's heavy set. Alright, so basically you want to prio health enchanted ward and then as much refreshing as you can. The only weapon perk that I use on armor is Sundering Shockwave. I think you could use Accelerated Resolve. I think that's like not a bad perk. I don't know that it's really necessary. I haven't really ever used it. But you really want to try and cap out on refreshing for Sword and Shield, because you got a really long AoE taunt and Defender's Resolve, and so any refreshing is going to help you out there. So Featherweight, when you're in light, you have to run that. You can't run Attuned Pants. You have to have everything in light anyway, so this is your best bet, because it gives you extra armor, so it really is great anyway. I put Relentless Freedom on there just because I'm cheap. A lot of my gear is not really optimized right now. I've been kind of not spending a lot at the moment to really optimize it, so there's some things that could be better. Relentless Freedom is just when I do run Greatsword, and I'm waiting till next season to put health on it when it drops. Health Enchanted Ward, Strike Conditioning's a little bit nice here in this dungeon because there's a lot of things that are like gorillas and mammoths that do a lot of strike. Sundering Shockwave on the armor. The shield, if you're running Butcher, you really need to run Night Veil shields, because the refreshing move is pretty much required for SNS. So it's 615 just again because I'm cheap. I haven't rolled a 681 yet, which I will do soon, but the difference in the numbers is not like super huge, but if you're optimizing, you're gonna want the higher level shield for sure. Butcher with the gem slot. Willpower is probably your best bet for a hammer. Sundering clear out on the hammer for sure. That's a lot of rend. And then refreshing move. It comes on willpower, but I'm not really completely convinced that that's the best third perk. I haven't really thought about like what you would run instead of it, but you got a ton of CDR built into the hammer tree that I don't know that refreshing move is really doing that much here. Like most of the time you're doing like an ability and then light attacking a couple times and then doing an ability, and refreshing move is not gonna make you do any less light attacks. It's just not that much of a cooldown. It only hits one target at a time, so I don't really think it's necessary. So Thwarting Strike, Sundering Clear Out, really two main perks you want on a hammer. Stone Form, I don't think there's really a reason to upgrade to 700. It's not, the 700 is not making any of the numbers for the Fortify any larger, so I don't think it's worth it at all to go to 700. Grove Light, I think ideally you want third perk to be fortified, although I need to test that, and I'm not entirely sure right now. So, at least the health and the protection, important. Party Slash Leeching, Earring, Despised is mandatory. Regenerating is really, really good right now. And for past couple seasons, it's given passive threat generation. So that's just easy aggro. And regenerating as a perk, I've always liked. I think it's pretty good. Third perk, Refreshing Toast. I'm not convinced that Refreshing Toast is actually absolutely necessary. I think when the math comes out to be that you're getting like a couple seconds faster on your health and regen pots, and I guess there are times, depending on what's going on, that you might be spamming some of your pots, but really as tank you're not using it, you're not using your potions that much on cooldown, and the extra 2 seconds is pretty nominal. So I think in a nature dungeon or an ice, you probably want like Purifying Toast, Despise, Regenerating. That'd be pretty helpful. Outside of that, you can maybe go Fortifying Toast, Despise, Regenerating. I don't know for sure. I'm not completely convinced that you do need or you don't need Refreshing Toast. Anyway, that's my light set. Heavy set is pretty similar. Health, Refreshing, Enchanted War. I haven't put health on this yet because I'm cheap. Sundering Shockwave piece. I think you prioritize Enchanted Ward over Grit Ward. I think Enchanted Ward is just straight up better most of the time because it gives you 4% damage reduction. It's active all the time, not just like it's not conditional like having to have grit. And most every attack, I believe, in dungeons is going to be heavy or light attacks anyway. So Enchanted Ward is going to apply to that. So, but Grit Ward's not a bad second. Health Enchanted Ward. Say the reason I use a round shield on heavy is just because it gives you this shield aggression to do a little bit extra damage. That's pretty much the only reason. And you don't do a lot, like, ideally you're not going to do a lot of blocking. You might block one or two attacks, and most of the time you've got enough stamina to be able to do that even with a round shield. So just that little bit of extra damage, and you're not going to be hiding behind a shield. You usually won't need a tower shield anyway. Same sword and hammer. Amulet, the only difference, and then got about 30% strike resistance. In this dungeon, on bosses, on the last boss, you pretty much need 0% nature, so you could go way more strike, or you could go some more elemental resist, but I find that strike damage is probably the thing you should be gemming against, like, on the elephant. Most of the damage that you're taking is just from him slamming you. Kind of the same on Kurok, I believe. It's mainly just I think my personal opinion is on bosses in this dungeon, you just want to be rending them as much as possible. So between sword and shield and hammer, you have like 95% rend, which is going to be reduced down on bosses, but to about a quarter of that, and that's still close to 25% rend. So if you're using all of your rend abilities, that's a lot of rend, a lot of utility for your team. And I think being in heavy and gemming against the strike means that you can just kind of sit there and not have to worry about a lot of the moves that the boss is doing, and just kind of rend a lot and keep that uptime up. Attributes. My attributes are pretty scuffed, to be honest. The way I have this set up, I believe, is just so that, because I have this one Dex Con Sundering Shockwave piece, and so kind of swapping gets a little bit weird, and I don't want it to, with the amount of magnify that I have, like a few pieces of magnify, I don't want it to swap on the strength, and so that's why I think I have a little bit less strength and more in dex. But in most dungeons you want to hit 200 strength, because any mobs that you slow or stun you want to be doing that extra damage to. Savage Divide, there's just not as many mobs in the main parts of the dungeon. I mean, that's really kind of an excuse. You pretty much always want to hit 200, so it's just me kind of having a scuffed setup here. So I've been trying to hit 300 con. You can do 350. The damage reduction at 350 is actually fantastic. But I've kind of felt like I didn't need it in most of the dungeons, so I've been trying to move down to 300 con, do that extra bit of damage. And I think ideally you probably want more strength. I don't know exactly. I don't remember exactly how much what the damage difference is, but I think you probably want to hit like 250 strength, something like that, and you want to make sure that you're hitting the 25 dex threshold at least. I have to do a little bit more testing, but I mean, the damage is probably better if you have like 250 strength, somewhere in that range. I'd have to test it, and then the swap here is just so that I can still hit the kind of okay stats. 200 strength bonus doesn't really work. It doesn't work on bosses, but the scaling is still better with strength on sword, and then if you're hitting with the hammer strength, obviously, so that's going to give you a bit of a benefit. Yeah, I think that pretty much sums it up for this week with the Savage Divide. All right. Thanks, guys. Catch you later. Peace. Oh, yeah. So I forgot to add that we used, I used a purple 4 potion. I made the Boon of Artemis. It's like the 3-minute one with 22% extra damage. And then here are my weapon trees. This is S&S. And this is hammer. I've been experimenting with this hammer tree. It's kind of like a all-in-one hammer tree. So usually you'll have Wrecking Ball here and then swap to Armor Breaker like for bosses. But in this dungeon, there are not a lot of mobs that really need to be CC'd or can be CC'd. It's not a lot of mobs like in general. We're skipping a lot of them. So basically just have Armor Breaker the entire time. Well, not basically. I do have Armor Breaker the entire time. So this is the tree. All right. Thanks again. Peace.